When using StatCrunch, we talked about the quickest ways to import some data into StatCrunch. sometimes, though, what you'll see is when you click on that little icon next to a data table, the option to open in StatCrunch won't be available. That's a glitch that I'm working to figure out why on certain assignments, certain questions, it is there, and then in other cases, not there. So if open in StatCrunch isn't there, the next best option is to select the copy table to clipboard. So if I click on that, it's going to tell me my table has been copied, it's ready to be pasted. I can switch over to my StatCrunch screen, which in this case I already have open, and hold Control and press V. And that'll just go ahead and paste that data directly into StatCrunch. So when I pasted that, I was just in this first cell. You want to make sure you just have that single first cell in a column highlighted, and then hit Control and V. Also something to keep in mind, if you're using an Apple with Macintosh operating system, whenever I use the control key for Mac users, that's the same thing as using the command key. I won't go back and forth between the two languages just because I'll forget to do that, but just something to keep in mind. The control key on a Windows machine and the command key on a Mac machine or an Apple computer perform the same operation. So this would be command V to make that switch. So that was for a single data set. If I skip ahead to, I believe it was question 7, now I have the two separate data sets. I can still do the same operation. If I click that little icon next to the table, I can copy to clipboard. Again, I'll get the confirmation that that's been copied. And flipping back over to StatCrunch, I'm going to click in the first cell where I have an empty column. And again, press Control V or Command V. And I'm going to get this menu, this paste preview that pops up. So basically what StatCrunch is trying to do is make sure my data gets pasted in correctly. And the way it's going to do that is by checking the delimiter. So the delimiter just means how's the data stored, how are these columns separated. For Pearson's products, for the MLP questions, a comma is going to be the typical value to use there. But you just want to look at this preview table and see, does that look like what you were expecting? You can try switching this to white space. So obviously we don't have a table that's going to be very easy to work with. All those numbers are jostled together. Tab is going to look the same, semicolon, none. So comma is the delimiter that gets that table to look the way we want it, with our list of country titles, the GDP in one column, and cellular data in another column. So try exploring with those different delimiters, but then if we click OK, we should see that data paste in. Now, I didn't actually copy over that first row. If you see this first column, or that first column, this first column is now var 2. StatCrunch just shifted my view over. So that first column is still there. StatCrunch just shifted my view a little bit. So I have the original data set I was working with. Now I have these three different columns for my data. And in terms of, for this question, calculating the correlation coefficient, I'd be using all the data in columns var 3 and var 4. So I hope that helps get around any of those issues whenever the open in StatCrunch feature isn't there. Of course, you do still have the option to manually type in numbers, but I would encourage you not to use that since that just opens up more opportunities for mistakes, very, very minor issues, typos that can affect your results.